AstroLab can do much more than just open images. The files from the telescope help us to do real science, and AstroLab guides us through this. Measuring the brightness of objects in space is known as photometry. To do this in AstroLab, you will need to make sure that you are using AstroLab Stellar. If you do not have access to this, then make sure you are registered and logged into the Schools Observatory website. You can directly open your image into AstroLab Stellar from the My Observations section of the website. Or you can download files to open them anytime. For downloaded files, use the Open an Image option in the File menu. This method is especially useful if you want to open multiple images to compare the brightness of an object over time. You can simply use the plus sign to open each one in turn. Or do a multiple select to open them all at once. To reveal details in your observation, use the scaling tool in the display menu. When you are happy with your image and want to start measuring the brightness of objects, simply open the Measure Brightness option in the Astro menu. To add a circle around the object you want to measure, click Add Target. You can zoom in on your image by using the mouse scroller or using Zoom in the display menu. You can then drag the observation until you can clearly see your target. I'm going to measure the white dwarf star in the center of this planetary nebula. You can now move your photometry circle onto your target. You can use the sliders to change the size of the central circle. This should just encompass the object without too much background. You can also change the size using the arrows at the corners of the target. When doing photometry, it's important to note that you need to not only measure your object's brightness, but the brightness of the sky around it. This is so that the background light in the image can be taken off your object, leaving the light from your object without this background pollution. The background light is measured in a sky ring around your object. This is the ring between the second and third circles. If there is a bright object in this ring, you can move its position to make sure you're looking at relatively blank space. You can use the sliders to change the outer and inner ring radius for your target location. Once you are happy, you can enter the results tab to see the total brightness of your object in counts. That is the photons which have hit your central circle minus the sky background, which has been calculated from the sky ring. The longer your observation, or the longer the exposure time, the more time the camera has had to collect these photons. If you want to know more details, you can explore the Advanced Options tab. Here it will tell you the exposure time and some information about the instrument setup. These values can be used to turn your brightness in counts into an astronomical magnitude by ticking the Calculate Instrumental Magnitudes box. You can also add errors to your values by clicking the Estimate Errors box. Now, when you return to your Results tab, you will see extra information, like the number of photons that have hit the camera each second of the exposure, the error on this value, and the instrumental magnitude of your object, again with an error. To obtain a true magnitude, you need to have stars with known brightnesses in the field to compare your value to. These are called standard stars. For most of what you will need to do, our instrumental magnitude should be enough. It is certainly enough to compare the brightness of different objects. Let's try doing that. We can look at another image with many stars in, like a globular cluster. Here, we can measure the brightness of many stars in the same object and compare them. You might want to do this if you're trying to create a Hertzsprung-Russell diagram. Now I can set up a target on the image. I'm going to zoom in to the outer regions of the cluster where the stars are more spaced apart and there'll be blank space around them to measure my sky ring. Add a target and adjust as before. You can use the zoom in view to the left to check that your central circle is as close to the star centre as possible. Now, if I want to compare the stars, it's important to leave my target the same size, so I can add another target which will automatically keep the same dimensions. If you accidentally change the size, you can readjust by selecting your preferred target and clicking the button that says Make All Targets This Size. Now set targets around all of the objects you'd like to measure. Select if you'd like instrumental magnitudes and errors calculated, and then head to the Results tab. Here you will see data for each of your targets, colour coordinated. If you'd like to do anything else with this data, you can download the results with a simple click and open them in a spreadsheet program. Please be warned that because we're using software in your internet browser, it does not automatically save what you are doing. So if you accidentally hit refresh, you'll lose all the data you've collected. Be sure to save things along the way. Don't forget that you can also save your image with the stars marked on by using the File menu. Have fun exploring the universe!